Every other animal can sweat and perspire. Why he created the pig not to sweat? People don't get that.
Why did he?
Because there's certain things of animals that was used not for food. And he was like, if you eat this, you are all cursed for life. Because some foods that you eat, you inherit what that ate.
So why didn't the pig sweat?
Why don't the pig sweat? That's what you asking me? I'm not God, I don't know.
Right, and that's it. See, and that's the thing, is that's what people want too many details.
But you see what I'm saying? I'm supposed to get you caught up on the same question. I don't know.
But I know what you mean. We do want to know, and there probably is an explanation, but at the same time, it's just a matter of the fact
and what you just did, and that's smart. That's when you got a good teacher that'll say, hey, I don't know, but you know what? Let me research it. When we come back,
but that's what I'm saying. That's what somebody asked. Well, why the pig won't sweat?
Yeah, I'm not gonna get up here and say, oh, because I said so. No, the pig don't sweat. I know that from research. But once I go back to the laboratory and I ask the professionals, I come back with the exact answer. But I know part of the answer because that's how their body is made up.
Right.
You know, because certain animals like the cheetah, certain things, they'll run until where they'll die. Because they'll just run, and their temperature get so high, they'll just... The hare, the rock badger, what scriptures you can find this in? Romans 14, verse 1 to 23. I'm always give scripture. Find it yourself.
Romans
chapter 14, verse 1 to 23. Deuteronomy chapter 14 and 8. Matthew chapter 15 and 11. See, I give all scripture. And Leviticus chapter 11, verse 7 and 8. Oh, yeah. You want more, Mom? Say, give me more.
Wait, I got to catch up.
Where you at?
Leviticus, okay.
All right. So here go more. As for seafood. Everything with fins and scales are allowed, but whatever doesn't have fins, like alligator, shrimp, is prohibited. Why? Say why.
Why?
Why do you think, Devin?
Well, that I'm not exactly sure, but obviously it has something to do with your health.
Exactly. And that's a scholarship. And the way you answer that, is the way a person that should ask anything they don't know.
They don't know.
Everything, I'm talking about health. So the logical answer is, I know it got something to do with health. They ain't right. but that's a logical answer. You're not going to get caught up with nobody, no word, like trying to get you caught up with your words. You think before you speak.
Right.
So why he tell you those? Because those are bottom feeders. Because they eat boo-boo. Because they're on the bottom of the dang old lake. They bottom feeders.
Right.
Certain animals with bottom feeders. Just like you're not supposed to eat certain carcasses that eat the flesh, same thing. If it says bottom feeders eat waste, where do waste come from? You. That's bottom feeders. Shrimp in the bottom, they eat boo-boo and waste. And there's certain fish that you buy when you get a fish tank to clean the dang old fish tank.
Mm-hmm.
How much?
Scum eaters.
Come on, the same thing, they bottom feeders. So you can get all of them, put them in your tank, and then clean all of it out of there. Flat out.
But you ain't supposed to eat it.
And thank you. But we don't learn how to make it, that trick or cook it. But it never was meant for food, D. It never was meant for food. We won't have nothing else to eat. That's a lie. All this other stuff he told you can eat. I'm about to jump into it. Afro seafood, okay, boom, boom, whatever it has
but
to be.
But funny, the things that we're not supposed to eat are the ones that taste.
That was just what you were talking about. It just tastes so good.
But we don't know a lot of stuff. We never tried it. We only know this because we're on this part of the world.
I know, but it's almost like...
It's commercialized, though. That's
yes!
All
exactly.
It's commercial.
Bacon is commercialized. Yep. You see it everywhere at every place you go.
Let me see. Oh, no. Let me see. I gave you for birds, everything is allowed except the eagle, the vulture, the kite, the raven, the ostrich, the seagull, and the owl. It is also noted that all winged insects are considered unclean. Also, meat cannot have been sacrificed to idols. Kosher. Kosher literally means fit or approved. Fit or approved. And is followed primarily by the so-called Jews and some Christians. The guidelines are the same as above and stated in Leviticus chapter 11, verse 1 to 47. So in the Orthodox Jewish culture, the only time you don't need to follow kosher guidelines is when, Devin, it's necessary to eat something unkosher to save your butt. So if you die and it ain't nothing left, and we got a whole bunch of pigs, we got to eat these pigs. Somebody, oh man, my God said, I can't eat the pig, and that's all, you're going to die. My God said, I can't eat the pig. My God said I can't eat the pig, but that's all left. Let me give you a good analogy of that type of story. A man in a boat, right? Everybody, you know, he's dying. He's like, man, I'm waiting for God to come save me, right? So a boat come past. They like, hey, man, get in. He like, no, man, I'm waiting for God to save me. Okay. A big old, what they call it, a cruise boat come by. Hey, I'm waiting for God. No. Helicopter come. Let down a little, climb in, you know. No, man, I'm waiting for God to save me, right? So he on the water. He about to die. He talking to God. He tripping. He think he see God. He say, God, why you leave me and forsake me? He said, I didn't leave you. All those people I sent, that was for me. That was me. You looking for some miracle. You looking for me walking on some water. You see, this all me. You out in the middle of nowhere and all these people coming. Coincidentally like that. Nobody come out here like this, on this ocean, and you out here and I done sent three people to save. You talking about you waiting on me. I sent my representative. You see what I'm saying? Same analogy. The blood of the animal. One principle I find very important is how animals are being slaughtered.
Like rare meat?
Yep. And according to the Old Testament, you are not to eat an animal that was diseased, died out of its own natural causes, or something that is alive. Also, here are kosher slaughter guidelines. These strict guidelines require an animal to be killed by a single cut across the throat to a precise depth, serving both the arteries, both jugular veins, both nerves, both trachea, and the what? And the what? What's next? The what? Eat what?
Esophagus.
Orthodox Jews argue that to ensure the animal dies instantly without unnecessary suffering. Come on, man. No pain, no suffering, no stress. A product that is certified kosher means a rabbi, somebody like myself, has supervised or ensured the food production follows.